What's up there? How's it going? This is the launch of a new project that I am planning to complete on a deadline this time, hopefully. And in today's video, I'm just going to be giving a brief introduction of what I am doing in this project and, well, what you can expect from this project as a whole. So let's go ahead and get started. Hello, everyone. My name is Grant Collins. I'm a cybersecurity student. And today I'm gonna be launching off yet again another project series. My last project was the complete Python project for cybersecurity, and I got pretty positive feedback in terms of what I was doing. You could say that the level was very script kiddie-like, but hey, you know, it's all about learning. So I am going to be launching off the next project, which is the Linux for Cybersecurity project part one. And I'm gonna be doing an overview of that right now. First, a little bit of rationale behind why I chose Linux as my next project. If you've been following me for a while, you will know that I did the Python project, and really there's a ton of projects I have on my agenda, and the next one is gonna be Linux. Now, I get a lot of criticism for my use of non-Linux. In fact, I really get roasted all the time about my use of not using Linux. But all kidding aside, that's not really why I'm doing this project. Really, ultimately, Linux is a great operating system and a great platform to really do some other great projects on. And so I need that fundamental base before getting into more sophisticated projects that have to do with either networking, security, or just anything in general. So I decided that, well, now that I have some Python knowledge behind my back, it's a good idea to get a good core fundamental base behind Linux so I can continue to do more projects with a Linux base. I have decided to break up this Linux project into two parts. If you don't know my project organization by now, basically I like to break up these projects into levels, and then I like to break them up into mini projects. Basically, the levels are where you learn, and the mini projects are where you apply what you just learned. Since Linux is such a big and sophisticated, and you can do so many different things with it, I've decided to break up this project into two parts. So part one is gonna be very basic stuff, very basic levels, very basic mini projects. Then level two is going to be a little bit more advanced, and I'm gonna have a little bit more advanced courses and a little bit more advanced projects. So this is part one introduction video, so let me go ahead and outline what I'll be doing on part one. I will start out this series with an actual mini project as the first one. Usually it's a level. And this is going to be loading a distribution of Linux on my home lab machine, a dual boot.
Pause. Okay, so while editing this video, I realized I said dual boot. Now, I will be doing a dual boot between Windows and Linux, but I will primarily, after my mini project number one, will be working with just VMs. I'm just doing this dual boot as a means to just kind of see how you do one and how you make one work. So, just to clear up anything, unpause.
Now, this is where it comes big, because a lot of people will be like, no, you know, Linux, and you know, you gotta use Linux, and you gotta use this Linux and that Linux, and
but what about Ubuntu Linux? Are you kidding me? Linux, Ubuntu, that's like the Windows of Linux. You need to be using Linux Mint. Linux Mint, are you kidding me? You need to have a privacy-focused distribution. That's gonna be Linux Tails, dude. Are you serious? Tails? You know what you need to do? You need to be an expert Linux, and you need to be using Arch Linux. Arch Linux all the way. It's what every person uses. Are you serious? You want to be a cybersecurity expert hacker? You have to use Kali Linux.
Well, I've decided to use Debian Linux. I know, the criticisms are coming in right now. And if you're gonna argue about which distribution of Linux to use, you're missing the point of this whole project. In fact, it really doesn't matter which distribution of Linux you use. Just use the one that you think and deem as fit. That is project one. Now for level one. Basically, I'll be learning the Linux basics using a website titled linuxjourney.com. And then we'll transition me into project two, which is called Linux Exploratory. I'm going to be creating and managing users, and then I'm going to be configuring common services such as LDAP. Level two is titled Some Security Stuff, with a lot of Fs. And basically, I'm going to be using a course or bundle on stationx.net called the Ultimate Linux Mastery Bundle. And then project three, we get a little bit of security stuff inside. We're going to be doing a firewall and an open PGP key pair. That's the basic overview, and that's basically it for the Linux project part one. Part two is going to have another three mini projects with a lot more advanced levels slash projects. I've used Linux before. I've used a lot of like basic Linux commands, basic Linux services, but I am a script kiddie when it comes to the depths of what you can do within Linux, but that's not the point. So that is it for today's video. There is a document in the description below that goes over, has all the links, and it basically has my part one project overview. So if you want to, and you want to give me some feedback, or you want to ask me some questions, you can always email me. My email is attached to that document. And of course, read through it and see what you can do to follow along. If you are someone who likes these kinds of documentation videos, please consider subscribing. And yeah, I'll see myself in project one, dual booting Linux. We'll see how it goes.